Usually you have two bones that make up the joint. So for example, the knee joint, you have the femur and the tibia. And the bones in the joint are lined with cartilage. That's what lets the bones glide against each other. In arthritis, that cartilage has become damaged or worn down. Unfortunately, we don't have a way to repair the cartilage. The cartilage has a very unique, complex architecture. So when the cartilage has been severely damaged to the point that pain is causing a decrease in a patient's activity, then the next step would be a total joint replacement. So total joint replacement is when we replace the surfaces where the cartilage has been broken down or worn out, and we replace it with metal or plastic or ceramic surfaces. Everyone's anatomy is unique, so the shape of your bone is going to be different from everyone else's. So you would want to put the implants in specifically for you so that the surgery is customized specifically for you. I take a high resolution CAT scan or MRI and I create a 3D representation of your joint. From that 3D representation, I'm able to model different implant sizes and positions and orientations in your knee. And I'm able to select the optimal position of those components and then construct 3D printed custom instruments for your joint. The way it's been done is that surgeons have used different alignment orientation guides during the surgery, and we know that they're not as precise or accurate during the surgery than if you use this technology. We know that patients who have had these custom instruments, they, after surgery, say that the knee or hip feels more natural. They require less blood transfusions after surgery, that their pain is less. We know that there's fewer readmissions to the hospital using these instruments. So there are big differences in terms of patient outcomes.